This is the Iron Trader. This is Sunday night. It's also Super Bowl night. So, as usual, we are going to review crude oil here and natural gas. This video is for information purposes only, not a recommendation to buy, sell any stock, commodity, ETF. Please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. All right, here we have crude oil daily and your weekly chart. Now, let's just do a quick review here. We had a really good week last week. Okay, we put in a bottoming tail here, and there's also an indecision candle, but the indecision got solved to the upside real quick. I also pointed out that this could have been a possible bear flag here going into that 21 day, but obviously this candle went up and went higher than what you have at the 74.52, so that negated the bear flag pattern. See, just like we had here. Okay, so when this ran up, we look at this candle. Well, this candle was actually the high was 71.96, but the candle leading it was 72.60. So see how that goes. So when you get a bear flag and then you put in a candle that's lower and then she comes all around, that's a perfect bear flag example. Now, this pattern was long negated. And we went all the way up here at a really nice green candle. Now here on Friday, well, again we held basically this support is what I was looking for. Okay, that's 75.52, and you held that very, very nicely. You actually even held that 75.85 level. So this was very, very nice. Went right onto it, but you look where it went. Okay, 74.53. So then when we look at the weekly on last week's candle, where did it go? Right there to the 50 SMA, 77.28. Okay, so basically, see, this is why you trade the charts. It's right there. The roadmap is sitting right in front of you. So when people say, charts are after fact, that's all bullshit. Okay, charts will tell you exactly where it's going. When I said we have an indecision candle, if this bear flag is negated, where's it going? It's going to this 50 day and it's going to that 200 day. Okay, so that's where she's going to go. So now what we have to do is we want to look at obviously Friday's high. Okay, so you want to look at the high, the low, and the closing. So for the high, we had a 77.29, and then the low, we had 75.93, and then you close at 76.60. So far, you're sitting at 76 here, 30. So we got to see where it's all going to shake out. Okay, so let's just take a look here at the upside. So you want to look at Friday's high. Okay, so you're looking at 77, 29, and then we want to do is we want to look right here, 77.28, as that 50 day is coming on down. That's going to give it really big, tough, strong resistance, and then right above that you have 77, 43. So that's what we want to look at is your candlestick, which is your support and resistant levels here, but your key resistant levels are going to be your SMA. So you want to look at that 77.28, that 77, 43. And then right above it here, we have this 21 day at 77.64. But you can see how that 21 day here, see how that's rolling over? Okay, you're about to touch that 50 day. So that might take that price right on down here. But we got to see how it's all going to shake out this week. Now, again, if you can get above this key, 77.64, you are be the 21 day here. Yeah, at 77.64. Then we have your 78.26, which is basically your 100 SMA here. Okay, so above that you have your big retest there, 79.29. Okay, so we can get a little bit more refined on that where you have a 78.11, 78.14 right there. But realistically, you just want to look here at that these key levels here on the upside. You want to watch that 50 SMA here. We want to watch that 200 day SMA. You want to watch this 21 SMA at 77.64. And then we want to watch that 100 day, and then you have your retest above. Those are your key levels here. Now, on the downside here, what do we have? Well, we want to always watch this 21 SMA here. But before we hit that 21 day, we want to watch Friday's low. Okay, so what do we have? You got 75, 93. If that's lost, we'll come over to this candle, which basically you have 75, 52, and then we can come to this candle, which you're looking at 75, 16. Okay, so we have Friday's low, 75, 93, 75, 52, and then with this candle, you're looking at 75, 16, and then we hit this key level, 74, 82. Now, right below it is here, we have your 8 day at 74, 50. That's going to be also key level. And then this 8-day here on your weekly chart at 74.38. Now, again, if this price comes down and you lose that key 8 SMA here, but it comes down and holds this 200-day, well, that's still good. Remember, this is a weekly. So for the week, you want to close above the key 200-day and above that key 8 SMA here. So if it comes down and it breaks this support here level here, well, then we know exactly where she's going to go down to that 72.34. But ahead of this here, we have this nice 50 SMA. Now, you can see the 50-day was actually on a nice good downslide here. But now you can see where she's kind of leveling off here. So we got to see how this all shakes out. Your 8-day was on the downslide, but now that's leveling off. Your 21-day is on a nice good upswing. So what we want to do for Monday is if this, this key support levels are obviously your SMAs, but what you want to watch that's this key level, that's 75.93, 75.52, and 75.16. But realistically, what you really want to watch here is this 21-day. Now, if it comes down to that 21-day and holds, then that's going to be a buying opportunity to take that back right on back up. But again, if that's lost here, you got that 74.51, and then we have that 74.38. So you're pretty much all right there in that 74 area. So if that does hold, you're in really good shape. Now, again, if that's lost, then we can come to the top of this candle. You look at that 73.82, and then we have 73.37, and then we have your nice 200-day sitting right below this here at 72.34. So you have some really, really good support here. Look at it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you got a lot of really good support levels here. The question is, which one is going to hold? Now, again, it might not do anything. It just might be a sideways action here. But if that 50-day is lost, then we'll just follow the candles down. Okay, 73.23. We have 72.38. We have 71.79. And then we have your nice 71.41 here. Then obviously your big retest here is going to be your 70.50, which is your price channel. Now you can see how the price channels here are really nice moving right on up here. See this? Right on up here. So now you have your trading range, which is 70.50 on the bottom and 79.29 here on the old top. Now, when you look at your RSI here, well, you're looking good. That can go either direction here. Your MACD here looks bullish, okay? So looks like the momentum is going forward. The green is over the red, looking not too bad. Now, this is the MACD I was watching here. So it looks like we have a possible cross here where your green is above your red. That's always very bullish, but we got to see if that's going to hold here. Because you have a lot of resistance here up overhead here now, okay? So that's what we have to watch. So just quick review here on the upside. Your key levels you want to watch is going to be this 50 SMA, 77.28, the 77.43, your 200 SMA, this key 21-day here at 77.64, 78.26, and then 79.29. So a lot of big resistance on the upside. Downside, key support, 74.82, 8-day, 74.50, 74.37, 73.37, your 50 SMA, and if that's all lost, then we come right here to your 200 at 72.34 here. So again, it's kind of hard to say. We got to see how Monday is going to shake out because a lot of resistance up ahead and a lot of nice support down here. But again, what I'll be looking for is a nice good scalp. If this would come right on down here and hold that 74 level, that's where I'd be a buyer here going into Tuesday. All right, let's take a look here and see what's going on with the old natty gas. All right, here we have natural gas, your daily chart. Well, we can see right now here, we put in and need another lower low at 1.783. So that 1.795, which was a nice good support, that is completely lost here now and it's just absolute waterfall. Okay, so bottom line is this here, when we look at your MACD, look at that momentum. Oh, it's right in the can. Look at here, your RSI here, that's going lower here. But again, there's gonna be an opportunity here to buy. Okay, so what we have to do is you wanna go and layer this. So you wanna look at that 1.80. Next is gonna be 1.817 here. And then this is gonna be the key level, is gonna be your 8 SMA here. at 1.964. But you see what I told? When his eight, that price gets below that 8 SMA, she just wants to just absolute waterfall right on down. You have to get above that key 8 SMA at 1.96. If you can, the next level here is going to be 1.99. We follow the candles up, 2.04, 2.10, let me see, 2.12. And then we have your big retest up here is at 2.16. This is your gap. This is where you want to be able to be. But again, it's all going to be over this 8 SMA. You need to climb back above that 8 SMA here to reverse this, okay? If not, it's going to be just like this here and lower, lower, and lower, okay? But again, if you can get above that 8 SMA, we look to this candle. That's your gap, 2.16. You look at the bottom of that candle, that's 2.42. There's your fill. So your gap and your fill. In the meantime, you got a lot of resistance. You got 2.23, 2.27, 2.29, and then we have here 2.31, 2.32. Then we just follow 2.38, 2.40, and then your big retest there. But that is all meaningless unless you can get above that key 8 SMA here. But it just looked like it just wants to go lower. Now, this here was the contract roll, and that was also when the U.S. announced that they were going to pretty much kibosh for now. They're thinking about reviewing or whatever their terms are, these 13 pipelines, which were in action for LNG, okay? So without that, there's no demand. If you can't sell your product, there's no reason. So realistically, it happened at the same time when you had that contract roll. But if you're putting, if you're trying to kibosh, trying to sell liquefied natural gas here, it makes zero sense to a guy like me. But again, that is what's happening. So let's look at some other charts here today. So let's take a look here on a weekly and a monthly. All right, here we have the old weekly. Well, you can see what's happening. She just fell just right off the old cliff here. Now, when you look at your 8 SMA, rolled over, 50-day over, 21-day, there's just absolutely nothing here, okay? Your green is above the below your red, nothing there. Your RSI can move. Still got room on the way down here. There's just absolutely nothing here that is absolutely bullish, okay? You have to get back above these key price channels here to do something. So really on your daily chart, bottom line, this just looks lower, okay? So let's look at the monthly and we'll show you where she's going to go. Okay, so today's low here, 1.783, okay? So this was the candle that I was looking at right here. This is 1.795. Okay, so obviously that is lost. So then we have to go here to the left of the chart here. So what we're looking for here next is going to be 1.64. Okay, we actually have a close, I should say, at 1.70. Okay, so that'll be your first one, 1.70, and then 1.64, and then we have 1.60, and then 1.52 we have here on this candle, and then 1.44. Okay, so that is basically, once we lost this candle here at 1.79, then we just got to keep going, got to keep going left here. So the next in line is going to be 1.701. That's going to be key. Below that, 1.642, and then we have 1.60, then we have 1.52, and then there's your big retest at 1.44. If 1.44 is lost, it's going to be man out the window time, and you're going to go all the way down to a dollar, if not even lower here. But we got to see how they are. Now, again, that's being said, you know, if we could get a reversal candle here and spike back here above this key price channel, see that price channel at 1.946? That's what you need to get back above, okay? And then we can shoot for that 8-day here on the daily chart. But you have to get back above in that price channel, and that basically puts you back into the game, okay? So again, just watch these key levels here. Basically, next one, 1.70, 1.64, 1.52, 1.44. Now again, for me, I don't really care one way or the other. KOLD has been a really good scalp here on the short side, but there's going to come to a time here that this is going to actually reverse, and it's going to shoot right on up, and they'll burn the people who are in KOLD. For me, it's just a scalp. In, out, take your money. So you don't want to go there and hold there and say, hey, I'm going to start getting short at this time. Okay, there's a little ways down here, But again, if this reversals, you want to look here now for either a reversal candle or a red dog where it blasts down and then finishes up. That gives you your buying time, your buying signal. Okay, so let's take a look here on a hourly and a 4 hour. Okay, here we have an hourly chart. You can see here, there's that 2.16. Okay, this was actually the gap fill right here. This was trying to be a retest, did not do it, it came all the way on down. So it just, you're putting in a series of lower highs, lower lows, but right now there's just no bottom here, okay? Every day you keep setting a new low here, okay? So you wanna watch that price channel. That's gonna be very, very key. You're at 1.78, you wanna get at least back of that, back up above that 1.817. If you can, then we have a chance at the 1.84. You have a chance at that 1.88 and then 1.90. This just has to be reversed, but right now it's just a downside pattern. There's no reason here that says, hey, I got to go long here. It's basically just a scalp short. So here's the same thing. 4 hour chart, really a whole lot of nothing. You can just see where she's just falling right over the cliff. You got to get it back above this candle here. This is going to be a big thing. That's that 2.16. Okay. So right now, let's just see on Monday here if you can hold this, try to get back and hold that channel, that 1.801 here on a closing basis. Just because it comes down here, that doesn't mean where it's going to finish. So if you get back above that price channel, then you got a shot back up here where we can, you know, layer it back up. But right now, it just looks lower. So I am completely flat. I have no position in that gas, long or short. So I just trade this every day because this is the widowmaker here. Now, crude oil, I will take a long and hold that for a long thing. It's just a lot different. But right now, the natural gas, it just looks lower. But I'll be looking for a scalp, maybe even a possible long scalp tomorrow. So I scalp the UNG for the long, sometimes boil for the long. So we got to see how this all going to shake out here on Monday. Okay, that's what I got for you on the crude oil and natural gas. I'll be back tomorrow morning before 8 o'clock, and we will do it all over again. All right, thanks for watching.